Hello friends, today we discuss about Perl program and how to make Perl program and run Perl program. Perl stands for Practical Extraction and Report Language. It was developed in 1987 by Larry Perl as an interpreter on Unix. Initially, Perl had an emphasis on system management and text handling, but with the help of subsequent revision, Perl also became capable of handling regular expression and signal and network socket also. So first, how to create Perl program? Go to terminal. If you are using the command prompt, then we have different files and folder available on desktop. How to check them? With help of ls command, we can check files and folders available on the current directory, because we are on desktop. So we can check different files and folder available on desktop. So I want to make new files, that is concatenation of two string. With the help of cat command, also we can create with help of vi command different program, get a symbol and concat.pl, because pl is a extension of Perl program. We are in the file. The first line is known as shebang. It tells the compiler that what we have, the Perl script. Again, we are using hash for command. We have print statement to print. Here we are using slash default tab. We are using dollar for variable. Standard input, because we want to enter first string with help of keyboard. Again, for entering second input, enter second string. In second variable, that is second underscore string, we enter the second string using keyboard. So we have stdin. So how to implement concatenation? We have a final string in which we have a concatenation result, that is concat string. Then first string, we have a dot operator to concatenate two string, and result will be in the final string, that is the concat underscore string. Again, we have the second string. How to display result? Again, we have print statement to display result of the final string. Then also we also find the length of final string. With help of length function. We are storing length of a final function in the variable that is string underscore length. So function is length, and we want to check the length of final string. The final string is concat string, so we have to supply variable concat underscore string. Now again print length of final string is dollar, we have string length, so this is the complete program. So how to check program? If we have the permission for the user to run this program or not. So we have the permission denied. So when we check the permission of the concat.pl, we have a particular message that is permission denied. Then we have a particular command to check the permission, ls space hyphen ld, and then the file name concat dot pl. So if we check the permission here, the author of the file or the user of the file have not the permission of the execution. So to make the file permission, we have a command that is chmod 7, then we have the file name. Then how to check? Again we have the same command. And if we check the output here, we have the X in first, that is user. So now user has the facility to write this file, read this file, and execute this file. Now how to run this program? First we check the file with help of cat command, that is concat.pl. This is a complete program. And how to run this program? Perl concat.pl. Now enter first string. For example, enter first string is Ramesh. Enter second string, Kumar. Now string after concatenation is Ramesh Kumar, and length of the final string is 13. So again we have prompt again. So in this way, first we have to write a program, then with the help of chmod command we can change the file permission so that user can run this file and execute this file. And after that we can check the output using perl space program name and with the extension .pl. So in this way we can write different Perl program and run them easily with help of Perl .pl file name, and then with the help of chmod command we can change the file permission, and finally Perl space Perl program, that is concat.pl, we can run Perl program. Thank you.